The moon was only half full, but it provided enough light for him to find his way easily across this unknown territory. When he came to the place Lucia had told him about, where the post and wire fence changed to dry stone wall between the front parts of their properties, he stopped to put on the night vision goggles and some fuzzy overshoes that would blur any footprints he might leave. He'd picked up a few useful tricks like that when working in dangerous areas overseas. As he clambered over the wall onto his own land, he was careful to make as little noise as possible, especially when he got closer to the group of buildings, even though he didn't think any intruders would be there this early. He walked round the area, checking, just to be sure, and saw no sign of anyone. Some of the houses looked almost normal in the dim light, though one showed its sad, ruined status all too clearly. He was sure one of the better houses would be the focus of any damage intruders might cause, because there wouldn't be nearly as much benefit to be gained by vandalizing the less attractive ones. He decided to keep watch near the first house, guessing that if anyone did come to cause trouble, they'd take the easy route and hit on the first building they reached so that they could get away quickly. In the meantime, he set a few little surprises to greet any intruders, then sat on a low wall and sent out an email to a group of people he'd worked with on and off in various developing countries. They were closer than most friends, felt almost like family, and they kept in touch, meeting up in person when they could. If any of them was available to help him during the next week or two, he was sure they'd come here, just as he'd go to their help if they asked for it. Some of them had admitted that they'd reached the same stage in life as he had, and were preparing to settle down permanently in the UK. He discussed it at length with a few of them the last time they'd had a get-together,